Well, what are we fixing today? Today we're going to find out what's under that tarp. I have mentioned the ultimate saw of death. That's it. We're going to get it out today and get it set up. And this might take me a couple days, so I won't say today, but we're going to get that out, get it set up, and cut some wood. So let's go look at that stuff, huh? That sounds like fun. Saw of death. You ever see those giant circular saws that they use to cut people in half on the stage? Yeah. Here we go. Well, here it is. Been in the tarp for a few years. I haven't seen it for a while. Let's get some stuff out of the way. Let's see what's under the tarp. Oh. Here's an axle. This axle is from the front of a lawnmower. And there's a very good chance that this is going to end up underneath this saw before we're done here. Oh, the belts out here. That was a bad move. I should have not left the belt out here, because that is garbage. Oh, I see the belt is kind of built in. So I'm gonna have to take that apart to get the other belt on. This belt. Well, anyway, it's driven from there. And the tractor powers that. And there's the blade. So there's the saw. You put the wood here, hold it over here, stand back, and cut. And that's hooked to the tractor. Sound like fun, huh? The only thing I don't like about this saw is, or one of the things I don't like is, when you go back here, it tends to drop it down towards the blade, right? So I think my plan is I'm going to block up that side a little bit, maybe, depending on what I can get away with the belt. I don't know. We'll see. Either way, I have to get this out of here. Get it closer to where I need it. I think the only wood that's on there is this. There's some punkiness. But that's fine. I put on some oak over here to try to keep wood chunks from falling into the blade and getting stuck into here and doing angry things. So that part's okay. That part's a little weak. I think we're okay. The metal looks okay. There's no blood on it, so nobody's killed themselves with it. Feels sharp enough. I don't think I need to sharpen it. But I'm gonna have to take that off to get to, I do have another belt, so I have to get the other belt on and see where that leaves me. I could adjust this anywhere I want on here. That's good. I don't know if I need to, but I could. Over on the tractor side, I gotta get this bucket moved, probably over there, and then I gotta bring the saw over here. The tractor has to be where it is, except turned around. So let's work on that stuff. We'll get her started here. I think I turned the fuel off. Oh yeah, there's a half a tank in there. So the fuel will make it happen, or can it work? Make sure it's right here. Need a key. Turn the electrics on. That can stay there. A little bit of throttle. Well, let's go. Choke. Well, I got the good belt that I had stored properly stretched out here. This is gonna line up with that, so I gotta go back a little bit more yet. That's gonna have to be turned on. The belt comes up, has to line up with that. So this can go back a little ways. Buckle that down. I got my D-rings cemented into there. Buckle this down, buckle that down there, so this can't move. I get this belt over that pulley, so I know where I'm at. And I have to make this pulley, which is now disengaged. All right, must be leaking some oil. Awesome. Oil leak somewhere. Anyway, I got to engage this, and that's done by loosening this guy and then putting it in and turning it until I get it to engage into the gear set. So let's get some tools. Okay, this is now in freewheel. This just goes into the power, into the transmission, and runs whenever the engine runs. So if you're not using this, it's best to disengage it. So it's been disengaged now for a while, since the last time I used the saw or the chipper. I'm gonna find some wrenches for that. Well, I don't see an inch and a 16th, but I got an inch and 2/16. That's too big. So we'll go with a bigger crescent. Okay, that's just a lock nut. It's loose. Alright, pack this out of ways. This has to come out a ways. If you look at what this is a bolt with a pointy on the end. And in this shaft, there's some indents. So I'm going to push this in where it's engaging, and then I have to try to turn it, the shaft, I think. One in a little. Oh, this is binding now. Come out more. On the edge of engaging. Okay. Now this don't turn, but watch what happens when I start it up. So there's not a lot of slack in there. I'm gonna grease this spot, see if I can take care of that noise. Oh, that's tight. Okay, a couple pumps in there. Put a couple pumps in these on the saw arbor. Well, this turns this way. That's got to turn the same way. Okay. I don't have to flip it around. Okay, that's pretty well tied down. I'm just gonna secure this other one. Let's raise this up a 4x4. The reason I'm taking this off is to get it over this bar, because I'm rubbing on the top of that too. Okay. Thank you. Well, that's what I'm after. Chunks of wood, about so yay. That'll burn nice in my pellet stove. All the sawdust that's down there, I can pick that up. So I don't care that it's a big kerf. Saw is sharp enough. Now I'm gonna grease that some more once my grease gun warms up. Because I think I hear some noise there. And I hear a little noise over here. I'll probably grease that one some more. But that's it. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm not gonna show you the whole biz, but that's how you do it. That's the saw of death. Over here, it's all the wood I'm gonna cut up with it. I might save some for a fire, you know, outside fire. I don't need those cut small. But, you know, that's what we're gonna do. Keep us warm this winter. I got some paper barrels that I'm gonna be throwing these into. I just wanna do a few to show you. And I think my wife has got a plan for us for this afternoon. So that's gonna sit like that. The bucket in the air, because I'm pretty certain I can't bring that bucket down. So that's my introduction to the saw of death. The saw of death. And saw of death, it literally is. You saw how close I was. I mean, you're right. My hands are right. See, my hands are right here. The blade is right there. So yes, I need to be very careful. I gotta make sure that all the area around me is clear. I don't trip and fall. I have to go over there and get some of that wood and bring it up over here. So I have something to pick up. Well, so I'll haul a bunch of that over here before I start a reel. I just wanted to show you a few and how it works. And that it works. It is what it is. I got it on Facebook Marketplace about 8 years ago. The guy says he put it together and just used it for demo at a fair, at a county fair. And then they didn't want him to have it there anymore, so he never brought it back, and then so he just sold it. Because it's a thing of beauty, and it's a thing of death. So, until next time, appreciate you watching me. If I survive through cutting this wood up, we'll have another video after this. So, watch for an obituary, or watch for another video. Thumbs up if you wish me luck. Thumbs down if you wish me no luck. YouTube-y stuff down below, subscribe and that. So until next time, remember, if you're cutting with a giant saw of death, fear no evil. Bye. Okay, a little bonus footage. As I was doing this, I realized that I took about a couple hours of video of me just cutting a bunch of wood. So if you want to see more of it, take a look. It's there's no audio, I mean, other than the sound of the saw. So, you know, I could use a few viewing hours from viewers. So if you want to help me out, turn this on, let it play. Give me a couple hours of viewing time. I could use it to get my numbers up so I can start doing ads that pay me instead of just paying YouTube. So give me a help if you will. Let the rest of this play. Bye. On we go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.